texture baking with spheres. Hey everyone, welcome back to Texture Baking Mastery. Today I'm going to be talking about baking with spheres and the different methods you can use. So as a general rule of thumb, I found that UV spheres work better than quad spheres. So to get started, if you go down into the description, there's a usually paid material, but I'm giving it to you guys for free. It's a Square Tiles procedural material, which you can download. And once you've done that, we'll just come to our file browser here. And you should be able to just find it in your downloads here. And so all you can do here is you just left click it, then you can right click and choose extract all. And you can choose a location where you want to save it. I'm just going to extract it into the downloads folder for simplicity's sake. And I'll just press extract. Then when it's done, you'll get a folder called Square Tiles. And I can just double click it to open it. And in here, you'll be able to find the blend file with the square tiles. So back in Blender, what I'm going to do is, first of all, we're going to add some spheres. So I'm going to press Shift A, and then under Mesh, I'm going to choose UV Sphere. And here in the bottom left hand corner, a little menu will appear. This allows you to increase the resolution of your UV sphere if you like. So maybe you could change it to something like 64 by 32, and I'll just double it. Yeah, there we go. A little bit more smoother. Then, of course, we need to make it shade smooth, so we'll just right click it and then choose shade smooth. Then I'm going to change from the timeline here to the shader editor, and I'm just going to pull this up, and I'm going to change it from line style here to object. And now if I left click this drop down here to choose my material, you'll see we won't be able to find it, and that's because we need to import it into Blender. To do that, we can just press File, and then we can just left click Append, which is like importing for Blender related files. And then if you come to your downloads, we can just go into our Square Tiles, and we just open up these folders, and I'm just going to import the basic tiles here, and then I can just choose Material, and then I can just choose Basic Tiles, and then choose Append. Then I can left click this drop down here, and now I can choose my basic tiles. Now right now we can't actually see our material because we need to go into material preview. So I'm going to come up to the top here and change to material preview, and right now you can see our material has gone completely black, and that's because we're in Blender 4.2. And as you know, there's a few settings we need to set up in Blender 4.2 to get things working properly in the material preview. So if you're in Blender 4.1 or earlier, you won't need to worry about this. So I'll come up to my render properties, and then I'm going to change render engine to Eevee. And if you remember, we can come down to ray tracing, and I can check this box here, and change my max roughness to 1. And there we go, now you can see our material is working properly. You can see right now, our material is being projected from the top down. That's because this is using a brick procedural texture, which if you remember, is one of the 2D procedural built-in textures. So in order to understand what's going on here, I'm going to come up to the top left-hand corner where the cross will appear, and then I can just left-click and drag to pull out another menu. Then I'm going to change from this 3D viewport here to the UV editor. And in order to see our UV, I can just press Tab to go into edit mode and press A to select everything. And you can see it's created a UV here automatically. And this is the UV that I like to use for spheres. Because of the way I've designed these node groups here, I can just use the UV or object switch to switch. And now it's going to use the UV instead of object. And you can see it's going to start projecting it a little bit better. But it's a little bit small, so I'll just change the scale to maybe something like 3. Or maybe 4. And then you can see that we don't have squares anymore. So I'll press Tab to come back into object mode. And to fix that, it's very simple. All I need to do is scroll down, and I can change my coordinate scale here to 0.5 on the Y. And now they're back to being square again. So you might be wondering if Smart UV Project is a better option for this, but actually the answer would be no here. I would say that I tested both of them, and I found that the default UV sphere, UV, works great and seems to be a lot less pixelated. However, I will show you how to UV unwrap other types of spheres as well. So what we can do is I'll press Shift A, and then this time I'm going to choose Cube. Then I'm going to press Tab to go into Edit Mode, A to select everything. Then I'll right click and then subdivide it. And in this subdivide menu, I'm just going to increase the number of cuts to maybe something like 16. And then I'm going to come up to Mesh, and then there should be an option here called Transform. And then under here, you can just choose to Sphere. And if you type in the number 1, that's going to turn this cube into a sphere. Press Tab to come back into object mode, and I'll press G and X to move this along. And then I'm going to right click and shade smooth. So now we've got two types of spheres. I just pressed S and then scaled it down. And then I'll press Control A and then choose scale. And this sphere here doesn't have a default UV. It's still using the cube UV. If I press Tab to go into edit mode, you can see it's using the default cube UV. But there is an issue with this, because if I press Tab to come back to object mode here and I choose my basic tiles material, you can see since it's using this cube UV, it looks very different here. And we're going to have to come up with a different strategy to get it to map out like it is on this UV sphere here. But I'll cover that a little bit later. For now, let's cover how we can bake these tiles here. So I'll left click this one here and just press H to hide it. And I'll left click my sphere here. And today we're not going to be baking any height or anything like that, since I went quite in depth in that in the last episode. Today, we're just going to be doing the color, roughness, and normal. So let's get started. As always, if I left click this node tree button here, just to keep your understanding strong, when we're baking the diffuse or base color, it's just going to be looking at this base color input from the principal BSDF, and that's what's going to become our texture output. The same will apply for roughness and of course normal as well. To get started, let's add a texture. So I'll press Shift A, and then under texture, I'm going to choose image texture, and then I'm going to press plus new, and I'm going to make this 2K. So I can just left click, quickly drag down, and then I can left click the end and then press Shift and then 8 to add a star sign, and then 2. And what that's going to do when I press enter is times both of them by 2 to make it a 2K texture. I'm just going to call this diffuse tiles, and then UV sphere, just to keep it nice and descriptive. Then I'm just going to choose new image. I'll keep my color space at sRGB, since this is going to be a base color or diffuse texture. And then I'm going to come up to my render properties and change my render engine from Eevee back to cycles. Then for our render, I'm going to change my max samples to 10, since we don't need a lot of samples, since we're not baking any lighting information, we're only baking basic channels. Then I'm going to scroll down to the bottom to our bake settings. If you can't see it, you just left click it to open it. And I'm going to change my bake type from combined to diffuse. I'll turn off direct and indirect, as those will take in the lighting into consideration of our scene, and we only want to bake the color on its own. Then we also have a margin as well. I usually just go for 16 pixels, which is the default. And once all that's done, we should be good to go. So I'll just left click my texture here to make sure it's selected, make sure your object's selected, and then you can go ahead and left click bake. Awesome. And when it's done, it should appear here, and you can see we have our texture ready to go. And it's just been baked on top of that default UV. Of course, we need to make sure we save our texture, since it won't be built into Blender. We'll need to save it as its own separate file. So if Blender crashes or we close Blender, we don't lose this texture bake. So I'll left click image, and then I'm going to choose save. Then in my file browser, I'm just going to choose a location, and then I'm going to create a new folder and just call it tile sphere textures. And I'll put 2K at the end as well, since we're making them in 2K. And I'll double click that to open it. And I might actually edit the name here and just make it tiles UV sphere 2K. And you can also choose your file format up here. But if you're happy with everything, you can just go ahead and press save as image. And now you'll notice the star has gone beside image, indicating that it's been saved. Remember, if you change any of the colors and you want to bake again and override this diffuse texture, make sure to come up to image and choose save again. If you have multiple images, there's also an option called save all images to save all of them at once. That can be handy if you've had to override a bunch of images. Then I'm going to duplicate this just to demonstrate how our texture bakes are looking. So I'm going to press Shift D with my sphere selected, and then I'm going to press G and then X just to drag it along, and I'm going to left click to save its position. Then I'm going to press the X on its material just to remove it. And I'll create a brand new material by pressing plus new. I'll press G with my selected nodes to move them along, Shift A, then under texture, I'll choose image texture. And in this dropdown, I'll left click it and choose the diffuse tiles UV sphere. Keep it on sRGB. And of course, we'll need to make sure it's using the correct coordinates. So I'll press Shift A, then under inputs, I'll choose texture coordinate, and I'll plug the UV into the vector. And then I can plug the color into the base color. And now you can see it's using our texture correctly. You will notice that at the top here, it's struggled to get these lines here. And unfortunately, that is a bit of limitation I found when baking onto spheres. But thankfully, it's not the biggest issue in the world, so we can just move on for now. I'm going to left click my other UV sphere here, and in here, I'm just going to left click my image texture and press Shift D to duplicate it. And I'm going to left click this X to remove that. And then I'm going to press plus new. This time, I'm going to call it roughness tiles UV sphere 2K. Then our width and height are at the right resolution, so I can just press new image, and I'll change my color space here to non-color. Then I'll come up to my bake settings here, and I'm going to change the bake type to roughness, and then we can just go ahead and make sure we have our texture selected and our right 3D model selected, and then we can just press bake. Awesome. Now you can see we've got our roughness map here. It's got some imperfections here, and of course the mortar is a really close to white color, since it's pretty rough on this object I made. You can of course tweak this, because you can see in the settings here, you can adjust the mortar roughness. So if you wanted to make it more reflective, you could decrease this number to something lower. Now we can go ahead and save our image. So I'll come up to the image with a star beside it and choose save. Then in my file browser, I'll just come to where I've saved my other texture and then choose save as image. And now it has been saved successfully. We're not going to do gloss today, since I covered it in the past two tutorials, and I think you guys should be getting the idea of how baking gloss works now. But if you are struggling, feel free to let me know. Then before I plug everything into this second UV sphere here, I'm going to press Shift D with my texture selected. Then I'll press X plus new. And this time I'm going to type for name, open GL normal tiles UV sphere 2K. So you can see I do tend to get quite descriptive in my names, and I'm going to keep the width and height at 2048 and then choose new image, and I'll change my color space to non-color. Even though it's a purpley colored texture, we do need to use non-color here. And then I'm going to change my bake type to normal, and then I can go ahead and just left click bake. Awesome. Now you'll see we have a nice normal map for our UV sphere, and we should be ready to go ahead and plug everything in. I'm just first going to quickly save this normal map. So I'll just press the image and then choose save. Then in my file browser, I'm just going to keep everything as is, maybe double check to make sure color space is still non-color, and then choose save as image. Perfect. Now I'm going to left click my other UV sphere here, and I'm going to left click my texture here and press shift D to duplicate it. And I'll zoom in to this dropdown, and I'm going to choose the roughness, and I'm going to press shift D to duplicate again, left click the dropdown, and this time I'll choose the OpenGL normal map. For the roughness, it's really easy. All I need to do is plug the UV socket into the vector and then just plug the color into the roughness. And now you can see these are looking really similar now. Last step, I just need to do the normal map. So I'll press Shift A and then under vector, I'll add a normal map node. This allows us to use a normal map. So I can plug this color into the color here. And also I'll hook up the UV coordinates with the vector, so it's using the UV map, and then plug the normal into the normal here. Perfect. That's that all set up. Now I want to talk about the other sphere. So if I just come up to my top right hand corner and left click this eye button, you can see we have this UV sphere here. And what we want to do is we want to get this texture onto here. But as you can see right now, if I press tab to go into edit mode, our current UV layout isn't really working well with this material. So we're going to need to use this UV sphere here as a reference in order to bake onto this one. But you also might be wondering, what kind of UV unwrap do we use? Well, I like to use a smart UV project since it's the most optimal option in our case here. So I'll press A to select everything in edit mode, and then I'm going to press U, and then I'm going to choose smart UV project. I'm then going to set my island margin to 0.01 and then choose unwrap. If I zoom in here in my UV editor, you can see this is the unwrap we've been given. And this is a nice easy sphere unwrap, which has got fairly optimized texture space here. You'll see though, if I press tab to go into object mode, it will mess up our shader here, but that's fine because we're going to be baking textures onto it anyway. So how can we actually do this? Well, the first thing I'm going to do is press this X button here to remove this material, as we don't need it for now. Then I'm going to press Alt G to return it to the center. And now I'm going to press S, and you can see I can change the size. And what I want to do is I want to make it around the same size as our sphere, but we don't want it to have any of the other sphere poking through. So if you want it to scale slower, you can hold down the shift key, and that will allow you to scale a little bit slower. And I want to get it so it's kind of just getting onto the top here. About there should do. And I can just left click to save that. Now the next step is the baking itself. So if I come down to my bake settings here, I can still keep my max samples at 10. I'm going to change the bake type here to diffuse, since we're going to start with our color. And I'm going to left click on my original sphere, which is the sphere underneath this one. And since we've already saved these textures here, I'm just going to left click to box select and then press X to delete them for now. Then I'll press Shift A, and then under texture, I'm going to choose image texture. And this time I'm going to press plus new, and then I'm going to type in the name diffuse tiles quad sphere, since this is a sphere made out of quads. I'll keep it at 2K and then just press new image. Then I'm going to keep my usual few settings, so indirect and direct off, and all these settings will be the same too. And all we need to do now is turn on our selected to active. So if you remember, the active object is the one with the white outline around it. And something to do actually is we've added this texture in the wrong object. So I'm just going to press X to delete this texture just now because we don't actually need it in here. And then I'm going to left click my cube here, press plus new to add a new material, and I'll press shift A, then under texture, I'll choose image texture. Now technically we could have just made our new texture in here, but since we've already made it, we can just select it from the dropdown and choose our diffuse tiles quad sphere. Then now we have that selected, I'm going to make sure I've got my cube sphere selected first, and then I'm going to select my sphere. And then what this selected to active is going to do is it's going to project the not active selected object onto our active selected object. So what that means is our not active selected one, which is the orange one here, the sphere, has our material on it. And that material is going to be projected into it, the texture, onto our cube sphere's UV, since our cube sphere is the active selection. So that's why it's called selected to active. Then once I've done that, I can just go ahead and left click bake. Awesome. And when it's done, you can see we've got our tiles texture for our quad sphere. Now I'll just left click my texture here and press shift D to duplicate it, and I'll press the X here, and I'll press plus new, and I'm going to call this roughness tiles quad sphere. and I can just press new image and change my color space to non-color. We also need to save our diffuse texture as well. So I'll come up to image and then choose save. And in the file browser, I'm just going to choose save as image. And now back to the roughness, I'll just left click this roughness texture and change the bake type from diffuse to roughness. You'll see our selective to active option is still checked, which is quite handy. And now just to demonstrate again how this works, first we select our cube and then we're going to shift left click our sphere in our outliner here. And that's going to make our sphere the selected but not the active selection. And then it will keep our quad sphere as the active selection. You can see it's got yellow text. So pretty much you want the cube sphere to be in yellow and you want the normal UV sphere to be in orange, since the orange one is just a basic selected one and the yellow one is the active, and we're projecting it from selected to active. And now we've done that, we can just go ahead and just press bake. Awesome. And now you can see we've got the roughness baked here as well. And now if we want to save it, we can just left click image and then choose save. And then in my file browser here, I'll just choose save as image. And finally, we'll left click this texture here, press shift D to duplicate it, X to remove that texture, plus new, and we'll call this one open GL normal tiles quad sphere. Make sure it's still at 2048 by 2048, and then just press new image. And since it's a normal map, we'll need to change the color space to non-color. And I'll make sure I've got it selected. And also, I'm going to deselect everything again just to demonstrate. I'm going to select the quad sphere first, which is the one with this material in it, and the UV sphere second. Then we can change it from roughness here to normal. Make sure all of these settings are the same. We've still got selected to active on. And we can just go ahead and press bake. And now we should have a normal map here, which we can use. So I'll then need to just save it. So I'll come up to this image button and then choose save. And in my file browser here, I'm just going to choose save as image. And there we go. Now what we can do is we can move our cube sphere. So I'll left click my cube sphere again. So we've only got our cube sphere selected. Then I'll press G and then X to move it along. And now to set up these nodes, it's very simple. I'll just left click and box select to drag them and just move them along. And we can plug this diffuse into our base color. And we also need to use the correct input coordinates too. So I'll press shift A, then under input, I'll choose texture coordinate and I'll plug my UV into the vector. This makes sure it is using the UV map. And I'm going to do the same for the roughness and the normal as well. Then the roughness can simply just be plugged into the roughness. And finally, normal map, we just need to press shift A, then under vector, we'll choose normal map, plug your color into the color, and then plug your normal into the normal. And there we are, now we've got our texture on our quad sphere. And if I zoom in here, you can see there is a little bit more pixelation than you will find for your UV sphere. Of course though, this can be reduced by increasing the texture size, such as increasing it to maybe a 4K texture, but I do feel like the UV sphere has the best value for texture space, if you like. So I tend to always go for the UV sphere for texture baking when possible. But yeah, that pretty much covers the basics of how we can go about texture baking onto UV spheres and quad spheres. Both options do require a UV sphere if you're using something like tile procedural material or a brick procedural material, because they use, if I come to my tile shader here and click the node tree, you can see they are using this brick texture here, which is one of Blender's only procedural 2D textures, and they require a proper UV in order to work properly. Of course, if you're using something like maybe a procedural wood texture, you wouldn't need to do that whole selected to active nonsense. Instead, you could probably just go ahead and just bake it straight onto a smart UV project onto your quad sphere. So yeah, hopefully that clears up a few questions you have about baking onto spheres, but I imagine it may create a few more questions for you as well. So if you do have any, feel free to let me know. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you for watching this installment in the course, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.